Thank you. graphics and the steroids, but it's that falls by the grace. And there's a requirement that we also need software to do the fundraising in such a virtual environment. We need to build enterprise and care funds to do the best things for the fundraising.
Kamera läuft.
this is another example from the real industrial application. This is a fill-finish production line for drops, the way you fill through vials, syringes. In the sense that you put a big box, you get some free supply there. So this is also some plants. Thank you. all the volume between buildings for the hotels, and then we kind of integrate the hotels and hotels. We try to create different colors, the events of the push wing, we have the position of the data set, and we can convert those areas to do a parallel situation. this is a brand new Sega. We're currently in part of the engineers on the different design of the PlayStation in the water. And we have to undergo water storage and elevators for pitch over here. And so the model we developed and is now used by different engineers in the project as we get to the design these skills of the PlayStation. This year again is important for the public. This is developing a new innovation concept. This is an advertisement. And the interesting thing about this elevator is this is our interest in our plane, but you can look at how that elevator works. And we've done this years before the first prototype was built. So this was last year when they actually built a real physical prototype. And we went and then see the real thing. And here you see simulations on that elevator. And then you can also simulate sources on the materials on that system, the lines. That's the key element of what we're developing. You can also display labels here in like sections as more like a head-up display, I would call it, but if you want to call it augmented reality, it should be an actual display. It's like overlay on the virtual console and virtual console. You can do this with head-up displays, but you can also use transferring screens. So this here is a transfer OLED TV. A very nice black picture. And it's just kind of in front of the model of the tower. Overlay over the physical objects as well. We recently started projects where we do something called Photoshop. Where We have goals which should not be there for color and protection. So I don't know anyone who's using this in real life. We have applications with either the data handball, or a secret point platform. We also use practical interfaces for this type of application, so we can use a suspect and a victim on a flash label and position them. They describe by one of them and then judge whether would be the desirable scenario for the protectors. We also apply this to virtual policy. We'll do this with the user, so they have policy standards and advise them and they regularly. So this is actually my polygon size. We have millions of little points on this scale, which represent the real room. And if I'm going to go into that room, and what they do is they take high resolution pictures of the blind spots on the wall. And there's lots of spots on the ground that are elliptical. That's what we can do in the machine now in the simulation. of the obstacles and then we can add gravity and higher resistance to that simulation. And then we get much closer to the actual quantum origin of our solution. And 3 weeks ago, I was on the panel at the pyramid, a couple of tests, episode 10 tests with different topics. It showed that we can talk on each other and connect to each other. You can see there is a there are formulas that you read to determine the velocity of a particle. If you only have the volume of the planet and the size of the spot particle, if you have all those assumptions, you can do the impact velocity. So this is what we're still missing already. But the problem is to get the volume of the blood flow. That's the time level. And there would be the time of it would be the five centralized drive against here. When you do actually scan the surface of the dry blood on the wall, and from that scan we can determine the volume of the dry blood on the wall, and then we can know whether it was a male or a female person, or the blood was from a male or female. So it's sometimes that we can determine the volume of the liquid blood. And then we can determine the velocity for each of these components and this here is the there was a lot of simulation results we could do. And you might see that the temperature of each of these lines is different because they have different velocities. And then we can get even closer to the atomic origin where we can start. By the laws of software to automate all that process to help them implement quicker. And then here is the visualization of one of the results. We can all kinds of boundaries, so you can also think of bringing this to the fine scene and hire creative bodies on site. A rare person must get things standing about it once it is trying to fill us. Literal depends on the process of how we have this here to the computer conference. This is a chat problem of a break for a higher audience. So this is a conference, and you can sit in there. It's on the screen, and you've got ceiling wires in your head. You can do this, you can hide out in your virtual world. And this is supposed to be a frequency flying, but it's also the YouTube makes me get sick. So the question is, what is a program? There are the real program is a picture, right? That you record with a laser medium that afterwards resembles the 3D structure. But it's static. So there are systems around that try to make you the same 3D but an interactive and good viewing of the image that just depends on the job. Well, that's, yeah, so that's not possible. Well, that does look like it. Yeah. So the problem is what we would like to have is awesome. So we would like to have something floating in space and we can look at it in 3D and we can walk around it and it would have a correct perspective. Right? that's what we want to have. But you can't do that. So what people do on the stage is they do something that looks like. It looks like if there would be a person standing, a virtual person standing next to you, right? You might have a little freaky effect. But it will lose perspective when you're not right. It only works for logins, which is sitting far away in the particular place. It's fine. But if you would want to do this to actually overlay the physical object correctly, that doesn't work. So you can see that picture. This is basically the exact thing you were talking about. It's a transfer screen, and we adjust the effect of the viewer, and then adjust the perspective of the virtual objects to actually match the real objects themselves. But, so, what we actually want to call that, then, is to call the adjustment. Thank you.